Yes.
Pastors that were going to pray, and yes, Craig, and all saints here, just thank God for His goodness and His mercy. You heard Him on the radio, and He truly is a man of God, and trying to live the life. Definitely a prayer warrior. Sometimes he'll get on his knees at the recliner, and after a while I get up, because he can stay down there for a while. I mean, like a couple of hours or more, and he's a good one. Well, that man, he loves the Lord, and he loves people. Definitely is a man of God, and he does preach the word. And we ask you to pray with him and for him and for us, that he continue to do the will of God. So let's congregation receive Elder Philander Moon from Vandy, West Virginia.
So glad to be with Pastor. Before I get up, you keep it up there. When I listen to be with Pastor here and Brother McCray,
bless you,
his great church, and the numbers don't mean a lot to me. It's just the Spirit of God. But to be able to come here to be with Pastor McCray and Evangelist McCray, glory to God, you great people, it's a joy.
Hallelujah.
Today, I know God has already said some things for us today.
Thank
you. Glory to God. And Brother Skip has gave his testimony, and I follow by something here. I try to get a little bit of a good topic. And I know I've been changed.
Yes.
Something, Brother Craig, means a lot to have a guy come. I always want some of the church folk have gone home, they got the morning service, and they've gone. But to come out and tell your testimony, brother, you don't know how much that means.
Amen.
To tell his testimony.
Amen.
And so much today.
Hallelujah.
And his deliverance.
Yes.
And I didn't know that all that was going on with him until I heard testimony. Learn more about it. Mm-hmm. One another through fellowship. I didn't know he was really that sick, a young person. And yet, God was leading him to a deeper walk of life.
Thank you, Jesus.
I praise God to be a part of his life, to know that one day Brother McCray will meet up in heaven.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I know I've been changed. Get up here. No, I might just sit back here. say glory.
That's right.
Glory. I might just say glory. I might just walk around and say glory. Thank you, Jesus. Glory.
It's a pleasure to be here tonight with Pastor McCray. Praise God. Glory to God. Evangelist McCray. Glory to God. And all these angels in this place. All these angels. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, glory. Song today, and we are standing on holy ground. How many of you standing on holy ground today? And I know that there are angels all around. Let them praise. We gonna praise. Spirit. How many people welcome the Holy Spirit in our life?
You're such a healer, hey, praise God. You got to do what you got to do. You forget sometimes. We don't even hear the Spirit. Praise you, Jesus, sometimes. Shalom, my quarter. Oh, I love the Holy Spirit. How many people love Him tonight? How many people filled with Him today? Those that listen to us by way of tape, you need to get filled with the Holy Spirit. You too, you need to get filled with the Holy Spirit. Praise you, Jesus. When you get the Holy Spirit, you receive power. Set your witness. You know the reason the world can't witness today, they're scared to go to Chicago, Brother McGray, because some of the pastors don't have anything. We started out on the streets preaching. We had power. They told us that we had to have Holy Ghost power to preach. My God, we preached on the corners and everywhere. I go with Mama. Mama went with us, praise God, Maine and Champion, Columbus, Ohio, Wichita, Kansas, Ohio State Campus, 8th and Indianola, Maine and Champion in Columbus, praise God, preaching, praise God, hallelujah. And as Pastor McGray said, people's cups are coming. If you are anointed, they're going to come. Lord, and He has timing for them to come. Glory to God. You just be on your doorpost watching. They're coming. They're coming. You just do what you're supposed to do. Now, come on, praise God. Now, come on, praise you, Jesus. Voice. Hallelujah. on the inside of you is what it's really about. Glory to God. Praise you, Jesus. Glory to God. Let's go to Psalm 16 here. Just briefly, Psalm 16. Glory to God. It's a joy to be with the new waves today. Praise you, Jesus. Pastor McCray, Evangelist McCray, glory to God, daughter here, and those who come out to give God the praise, and those that listen to us by way of tape. It's a joy to be in God's house. It's always a joy to be with Evangelist McCray. Glory to God, hallelujah. We go way back when Mama was with us. Praise you, Jesus. Glory to God. Sister McCray at the time. Praise God. Now the other, praise God, we got Sister McCray here with us today. And praise God, taught us under that tent on top of the hill. Glory to God. He had a great heart for God, still has a heart for God. Praise you, Jesus. And to be here in your place again to give God the praise. Not only to be with you long, praise God, we've already had a great time worshiping. Praise God. Listen to Brother McCray saying, I just was blessed. And the praise group and the testimonies today is blessed. Glory to God. It's a blessing to be able to praise God. It's a blessing to be in the house of God. Glory to God. Enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. Brad, bless his holy name, for the God is good and his mercy endures forever. Glory to God. The Psalms here, it's the 16th chapter, praise God. We stand for just to read a little bit of the reading of the word. Psalms chapter 16, verse 7. I will bless the Lord who has given me counsel. My heart also instruct me in the night season. I'll set the Lord always before me, because he is at my right hand, good God Almighty, and I shall not be moved. Therefore, my heart is glad, and my glory rejoices. My flesh also shall rest in hope, for he will not leave my soul in Sheol, nor will you allow your Holy One to see corruption. You'll show me the path of life. And in your presence is fullness of joy. And at your right hand, there are pleasures forevermore. Taken from this text here, 11th verse, I'm going to use a subject this evening. I'm going to stay in your presence. I'm going to stay in your presence. Just bow our head. Lord, we thank you for your word. Your word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path.
to understand your word. And Lord, help me to be a tool of your word. Help me to be the living epistle that men throughout, praise God, the world may read and ask the question, what must I do to be saved? Enable me to give an answer of the hope that I have within me. In Jesus' name, we pray. And all the people of God say amen.
Amen.
This song here is a messianic song. David is making reference to Jesus Christ. David is mentioning this Jesus who would die for the sins of the world and would not see corruption. It's this David, praise God, who is saying, I have set the Lord always before me because he is at my right hand. Note in verse 9, he says, therefore my heart is glad and my glory rejoices. I don't know about you, praise God, but sometimes, praise God, they say that when you rejoice in the Lord, praise God, your face will shine. Yeah. When you feel good, praise God, hallelujah, we have something to rejoice about. Here in the 11th verse of this psalm, praise God, you will show me the path of life. Here, at times, as we live today, we need Jesus to direct us. Glory to God. We need Jesus to speak to us. Some say in the New King James Version of the Bible here, it says with this phrase, David speaks of his escape from death at a critical point. But he also indicates the eternal life is given. Here it is, by the resurrected Savior to all who trust in him.
Yeah,
glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. If you can just trust in Jesus, thank you, Jesus, everything is going to be all right. In Proverbs chapter 3, praise God, it says, trust in the Lord with all of your heart and lean not unto your own understanding, and in all your ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct your path. Glory to God. In other words, if you put God first, praise you, Jesus, in everything you do, praise God, he's going to direct your path. Glory to God. Come on, clap your hands and give him some praise today. Glory to God. And in your presence is the fullness of joy. Glory to God. What is David saying here? In your presence is fullness of joy. Glory to God. I heard someone say today in Peter, praise God, Peter says, count it not strange concerning your fiery trials. Come on, praise God. Glory to God. It talks about, praise God, after a while, it's going to be all over, Brother McCray. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy is going to come in the morning. Pain is, praise God, very epidemic today, but praise God, hallelujah, if you just take it, praise God. His anger, praise God, is just going to be for a little while, but his favor is life. Lamentation says this, great is thy faithful, always to somebody. Help me here. Day by day and morning by morning, new mercies I see. What does David mean when he says that in your presence is fullness of joy? What does he mean here in this psalm? Praise is in you. Praise you, Jesus. Well, Peter says, hallelujah, none of the trials that we're dealing with and all that we're going through, he says this, Brother McCready, kind of not strange. So much folk are dying and tribes of people being scattered abroad, people persecuted. But if it did it to Jesus, they gonna do it to you. But he says, knowing this, that a new heaven and a new earth is going to be prepared. The earth is going to be renovated, praise God, and I see a new Jerusalem coming down out of heaven. Prepared, yes, brother and sister McCray, the newlyweds as a bride adorned for their husband. Come on, praise you, Jesus. So then he said, I can rejoice with joy unspeakable and full of glory. Have you ever been so happy that you didn't have any words? You see, the word awe comes, you just struck out of it. Glory to God, you have. Somebody said you're so happy that you praise God. It's Dallas Holman praise. You used to sing a song, I'm so happy I can't hardly praise God speaking. You rejoice with joy unspeakable and full of glory. But how do you get in his presence? Glory to God. Oh, glory, what is his presence? Glory to God. We find out, praise God, that in his presence, praise God, is joy unspeakable and full of glory. Glory to God. The psalmist said, who shall ascend into the holy hill of God? Who can get there? Now at that time, praise God, the Ark of the Covenant was there. But now, praise God, hallelujah, we don't have to worry about the Ark of the Covenant. We got the Holy Ghost on the inside. Greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. Praise you, Jesus. I can get there, praise God, when I do the necessary things. When I repent of my sin, get some of those who want to get into his presence that listen to me by way of tape. Yeah, Brother McCray, you can get into his presence and you can get translated into a new kingdom when you repent of your sins. Turn away from what you're doing and turn to God. Yeah, I'm in an apostolic church, and so I can preach the doctrine. Jesus for the remission of sin, and you receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. God, and you, praise God, and can come boldly to his throne. Now the veil of the temple had been ripped over to God. Hallelujah. And all you can do, that 4-inch thick veil had been ripped, praise God, and you can get to him. Don't have to go through no Catholic priest to get to God. Yeah, glory to God. There's one Father, and he's in heaven. Glory to God. You get to him, praise God, and get to his presence. Oh, the writer of Hebrews says, you can come boldly to the throne of God's grace. What the text is saying. The text is saying that, praise God, you can get in his presence. Glory to God. Glory to God. Praise God. David is saying there's a good thing to be in his presence. Some folk are in the presence of kings. Some folk are in the presence of political figures. Oh, glory to God. But give me one night, not with King Saul or King David. Give me one night with King Jesus. Yeah, I can get to King Jesus. some praise. Give him some praise. In his presence is fullness of joy. I've got to get there. I've told you, those who are listening to me, and praise God, they don't feel the joy and peace. Now, this is applicable. There's a correlation here in the 16th verse to our life. He will not leave our soul in the grave. He will not suffer us to see corruption. For in the moment of a twinkling of an eye, come on, church, for the dead in Christ shall rise, and all their lives shall be caught up to meet Jesus. The death can't hold this body down. Grave can't stop you. Paul says, praise God, in 1 Corinthians 15, praise God, talking about, praise God, Jesus coming back. Praise God. He says, be steadfast and unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For such as you know, your labor shall not be in vain. Glory to God. So stay in his presence. And it shows you how to get into his presence. And receiving that Holy Spirit and that gift of the Holy Spirit. And as you receive the gift of the Holy Spirit, praise you, Jesus, glory to God, you can come boldly. Now, there's something that the Holy Spirit is whispering to me today, and I want to say it to you. You receive the Holy Spirit because he's on the inside. And as you receive him because he's on the inside, huh? Glory to God. Paul said it this way. If the Spirit that raised Jesus from the dead dwells within you, dwells within you, he shall quicken and make alive your mortal body. Come on, praise you, Jesus. And so, praise God, not only, praise God, hallelujah, are you in his presence, but the presence is in you. Thank you, Jesus. Glory. Now, in John chapter 7, that last day of that great feast, Jesus is, praise God, brothers is trying to get him to go. And he says to them, I want to, praise God, if you be the Christ, how long, praise God, will you stay incognito? Other words, he says, I want you, praise God, hallelujah, to go and show your power. Jesus waits to the last day of the feast. And he goes up, and Brother McCray, he breaks protocol. Rabbis would sit in this seat, but Jesus came in, and no one, he broke up the feast and says, if any man thirst, let him, praise God, come unto me and drink, as out of your bellies shall flow living water, rivers of living water. Come on, praise you, Jesus. Glory to God, a type of Holy Spirit, praise God. Glory to God. How do you get there? Praise God. Well, receive the Holy Ghost. How do you stay there? Praise you, Jesus. In his presence. Pray in the Holy Spirit. Jude says, build yourself up on your most holy faith, praying in the Spirit. Glory to God. In his presence. Lord, I don't want to go nowhere else. I don't want anything else. All I want is you. I want to stay in your presence. Somebody says, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I won't be shaken. I won't be moved. But I'm going to stay with you, Jesus. Glory to God. You see, sometimes, praise God, we get shaken. Praise God. And we'll be led astray from his presence. To be in God's presence, scripture come to me now. And I'm thinking about something here that comes to me. It says that the Lord inhabits the praises of his saints. Hallelujah. What does the psalmist mean here? That the Lord inhabits the praises of the saints. But he's simply saying that if you will allow me to walk in your church, glory, glory. Glory, glory, glory to glory. Somebody said that a long time ago, those who just give a little theology behind it, that the old economy of God spirit, praise God, or praise God's spirit or presence has to do with breath of God. Under the old economy of God, it says that, praise God, God dwelled in the holies of holies. Some of the people say that you could hear him breathe in the back, the breath of God. And so then David says, the Lord inhabits the praises of his saints. What he's saying, the psalmist is saying here, that if you allow God to come in your church and walk down the aisles, praise God, and fellowship with you, glory to God, something is going to happen. Oh, when you come back home, you take something with you. Thank you, Jesus, praise God, because you're in his presence. And David says that in his presence is the fullness of joy. Why did David say that? David knew that if you get Jesus in your presence, there is joy unspeakable and full of glory. Clap your hands and give him some praise. Hallelujah.